telling me that it's solar cult theology. Yeah, you know, or stellar theology, and we're on the same page. Tell me that the Bible is Druidism, and I'm on the same page. But tell me that it's history of things that physically happen in time and place, you know, no way.
Look how much money is going into researching or verifying the Bible with our archaeology.
And who funds those guys?
Who funds
that appear on Time magazine cover and are always on the Discovery Channel with their million-dollar programs talking nonsense.
Jesus
More
tomb
lies.
Or,
yes.
Herodotus tomb. Or
well, these are the modern-day Herodotuses.
Yeah.
You see, Herodotus, Pliny, Tacitus, Josephus, they're all under Roman patronage, royal patronage. Their checks were paid by the top boys. It is no different today. Most of the historical faculties, most of the scientists who are getting the real budgets are those who are endorsed by a system. If you break the system like a man called John Allegro did, to the Dead Sea Scrolls scholar, another name for people to realize, John Allegro, you're finished. Emmanuel Velikovsky, you're finished. You start off like us, hey, you're a great boy, you're doing well. Wait a minute, what are you doing now? You're refuting? You dare to refute the pack of lies that we've been telling you? All right, you're done. Commons Beaumont, Connor McDowry, Ignatius Donnelly, you know, the list goes on.
I mean, damn, Mike T. Why you had to come at them niggas like that, bro? You didn't have to go hard on them niggas like that, right? You know what I'm saying? You could have cut them niggas some slack. Know what I mean? Alright. Yo, what's going on, peeps? This is Sony Legend, SLO1, checking in with y'all once again. If y'all didn't know, that's your boy, Michael Tesarion, in the intro right there. He really, in many ways, set the stage for this session today. Straight up, so... Anyhow, I don't have much time on this one like I do on the others, but I'm going to just go ahead and cut into the topic. You know me. Name of the session tonight is When Your Thought Process is Obsolete. Once again, the name of this topic tonight is When Your Thought Process is Obsolete. Now, just think about that title and topic. I'm going to just go ahead and let that marinate in. What can I possibly be talking about when I say your thought process is obsolete? Well, just think, everything you do requires a thought before an action, and your actions are not doing anything at this point in time but maintaining status quo. And if you swear that you're such a revolutionary, I mean, if this part of your blood, if it just is in your DNA that you're a revolutionary and you're about revolution, then your thoughts and actions should reflect that of revolution. That's rule number one right there. Because, my nigga, you're not handling no business if you just steady going through the motions. That's just for the record. You know what I'm saying? You're just doing the same old, and expect different results. That's just not going to cut it. It's just not going to cut it. But anyway, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I guess, hey, you know, talking to people, ultimately, you know, when they realize the magnitude of what's going on, it can scare them. I can understand that. It can scare them. But I will state this. What I find is a lot of people that come at me as a rebuttal, you know what I'm saying? They will just say, hey, just remain calm. It's going to be all right. I'm like, bro, what are you talking about? It's not going to be all right. You know what I'm saying? But then I realize who I'm talking to. And then understand this, a coward will tell you to remain civilized while there's uncivil shit going on all around you, all around you. And that's one thing that I had to realize, you know what I'm saying? That, you know, these people are not going to fight. They don't know what to fight for. And, you know, they expect, and they're really, in many ways, they expect the government to save them on every account. How did people become tamed like that? That's my question. How did you become lame like that, B? How can you call yourself a warrior? You know what I'm saying? All this shit you talk, you know. But when niggas start kicking in doors, it's going to be different, B. You're going to see a lot of niggas that talk all this shit. When they kick in doors, they're going to lay it down. And they're going to use that shitty ass excuse, I got a wife and two kids. Don't hurt me. But my nigga, you knew everything was going on. You talking some big shit at the house. What happened? But you know, hey, niggas not ride or die. You know, they like to dabble. You know what I'm saying? They think they know what the fuck going on, but they be dabbling. My nigga Mike T, tell them about them dabbling ass niggas.
Like, I'm dabbling in this. Oh, I dabble in that. Yeah, I read Zechariah Sitchin. I picked up a David Icke book. I'm a bit of a dabbler. I listen to Alex Jones. You know, okay, wait a minute. Where are we going with this? You know, it's like...
It's not really application of the information itself, but it's more like being knowledgeable about all the...
Well, it's another bandwagon. It's another flavor of the month. You know, I know many people. In fact, most of the people that I know that I, you know, have come across in my life are dabblers just like that. It's just something they're going to do today, and then tomorrow they leave it.
Sure.
They have no real passion or interest in it at all.
Exactly, my nigga. Exactly. You know. And a lot of fake-ass niggas like to come at me and say, you know, well, y'all alchemists and Egyptologists to study Kemet and the sciences, you know what I'm saying, the mystical sciences, metaphysics. All y'all niggas do is just worship the sun. And I'm looking at y'all. I mean, come on, B. You can't be serious with that statement. You understand? We are all about being universal soul beings. How the fuck you gonna say we worship the sun? You know, we're universal, but we're gonna worship one sole object within this universe. You sound like a stupid ass nigga, bruh. And that's for the record. You understand? I mean, it's like this. And let me have to break it down to you, okay? If there wasn't no sun, we wouldn't be having this fucking conversation right now. You understand what I'm saying? There would be no life on this fucking planet. You know? I mean, hell, stars are born and they die every day in this universe. If it would be one day, the sun just say, fuck it, I'm gone. That's that. No more life. Hell, won't be a solar system no more. Call that shit something else. But at the end of the day, within the universe, there will be life. Life will go on, bruh. So don't come at me with, we worship the sun. We idol worshipers and we put all our soul interest in the sun. No, bitch. We acknowledging the importance of the sun being placed where it's at within our environment, atmosphere, galaxy, solar system, whatever you want to fucking call it. And it's sustaining and providing life on this planet. And without it, there will be nothing else to fucking talk about. Let's start there. But you know, hey, that's the name of the game. That's how niggas play, son. You know, they don't want to be stuck on stupid. Let them. I want a nigga to bring it to me. But all they do is dance around me. Y'all niggas some bitches, man. Straight up. I do not respect a coward, bruh. I do not respect a fucking coward. But anyway, that's my time. This is only legend. And I'm just going to go ahead and say this before I be out. Nigga, you climb that fucking mountain. That's all you.
But see, those are people who are exhilarated by the fact that they're seeing a greater and greater landscape. Mm. And that is exhilarating. Mm. Just in the same way as you're climbing a physical mountain, you don't go back because there's no going back. Mm. And when you finally get to the top, you see you have a vision of both, of all of it.
Mm.
You know, yeah, your territory is pretty small what you're standing on, but look at the what you see. You have a rare and unique vision of the whole of life and the whole of the meaning of life.
Yeah.
And the most important thing is when you arrive at the peak is you have not asked somebody else to bring you the mountain.
Yeah.
You haven't asked somebody else, hey, so what's this like? You know, you're living beside the mountain and go, hey, tell me all about it.
Yeah,
exactly. You know? And you have, because today what we have is a world of people who don't want freedom or enlightenment. They want people to give it to them.
Mm.
I'm just a voice who comes in and go, hey, stop. Can you stop asking this guru, this priest, this teacher, this freaking general or this, you know, politician to give you something that you can actually attain yourself? Are you really interested in enlightenment, or are you more interested in Big Daddy giving it to you? Well, I know what the answer is. They're interested in Big Daddy giving it to them. This is what has to change. Yeah, you have a right aspiration. It's good to aspire towards enlightenment, but it's wrong to aspire to someone else to give it to you.